Hello everyone, welcome back if you've been here before or if you haven't already. I'm Ryder Tweedie and this is my YouTube channel. So I usually do a lot of photography work and drones, kind of all of that, but I'm also a surfer and a snowboarder, as you've probably seen on this channel. And in this video I thought we'd try something new and we'll do a leash plug installation on this brand new shape I've just done. So this is the RT Shapes Frother series. If you want to check me out on Instagram, where I post all my boards and other shaping stuff, that is linked below. It's RT Shapes. And yeah, so we'll get into it. We'll just go through all the steps of installing one of these little guys. And yeah, it shouldn't be a very long video, pretty straightforward. But yeah, if you don't know, hopefully this helps out. So we'll get into the video. Yoo! So first things first, you obviously want to have all your safety equipment. So put all that on, or at least just have it. So you're going to want some eyewear and a mask and then earmuffs if you can, just to protect your hearing. So the first thing we're going to do is we'll go down to this little guy and you're going to draw around it. So the easiest way I find to do it, if you've got one with these two little studs, is I actually flip it upside down and then I line up the little studs like that with the stringer and then I trace around it and then we turn the router on and cut it out. So let's do that first step now. All right, so here we go. I will line that up with the stringer. I want to put it right about there. Then I like to put one finger on it and go around it just like that. And then you're going to want to just fix up them last little bits. And there you have it. Okay, so now's the step of setting the router's depth, which is how far down it actually digs into the board. So mine's actually preset on this. Hopefully you can see that well. But you want it to go to just above the little nook here, so it sits down nice and deep, and these little stoppers should stop it from going any deeper, if that makes sense. So you just set your router depth so that it cuts just above that little bit there. So now we shall plug the router in, put all our safety equipment on, and start routing out the hole. One thing I forgot to mention, just make sure to tape off a little area and then you draw onto the tape. This just also keeps it from, when you glass it in, any resin spilling outside your cut area. So yeah, just put a strip of tape there. Awesome.
Start it on an angle, turn it on, and then I'll route out the hole. So yeah, let's do it. Just so good at being in trouble. Spending my days out in the ghetto. Mama say that I need to be careful. Going downtown on the blue line metro. Car overheated and I can't afford a rental. Broke down Chevrolet sitting on Central. Turning up my headphones, looking out the window. Laura Hill playing it could be.
All right, so there you have it. That's perfect. So it's a perfect circle. You just got to be easy with it, you know, and just take your time. If you're just using a router, I know a lot of other people, if they have the tool, they just have that the one like circle thing and then they just chip out the wooden stringer. But for me, the router works best. I just follow the line and go around it. And that's practically it for the routing out part. And we'll now start the sinking of it and glassing it in. All right, so obviously if you have any of the tape left behind, you want to try and rip that off, because you do not want any tape to be stuck in with your resin. So any little excess bits around the outside of what you just cut need to come off. So go grab yourself some tape and you are going to tape a little reservoir. Make sure that none of the excess resin runs out. You've got to get a little bit of tape, so a little square like so, and you just want to put that over the top of that in case any excess goes in. You wouldn't want to be trying to get that out, it'd practically be ruined. So just make sure you got a good seal on that so no resin gets inside. Alrighty, so here we are. Sorry if there's a bit of noise. This is my resin drum, quite a big resin drum. And the first thing we're going to do is just have a little tub like this. Sorry, this one was just glassed. I put another leash plug in before I did this one. So there we go. Get the mixer all ready, little spatula thing. I've got a little bit of foam dust. I want to add just a touch of that in. So if you're wondering how much that was, it was just a real little bit of foam dust. This is just to add a little bit of strength when it does actually hit the foam. And now I'm going to turn the tap on and just add a real little bit of resin. I won't be able to film this step, but I'll show you how much I add in 1 second. So literally just one drop of resin, not much, just enough to hold it in. And then we just are going to mix the foam and the resin together. Mix until you think you're done and then mix some more. There we go. Now we're just going to add our catalyst, which will make the resin go off. I'm going to make it go off in about 5 minutes. There's just a few little drops, so let's go. 1, 2, 3. That's probably a bit too much, but it's not an application that you need time, so it should be fine. And I'm just going to mix the catalyst in, and I'll see you back when we're sinking the box. All right, so catalyst is now all mixed in, and I will quickly go back to our fin box bit. Okay, so I'm going to get the resin that we have mixed up, give it just one final little mix, and then just pour it into the box just enough. So apply a little bit to the walls of the fin box. That should be fine because it's going to get saturated anyway. Chuck that little guy back in. Push him down, make sure it's lined up straight, or you're going to have a crooked metal piece. There we go. Should look like this with resin overflowing all around it. So that's perfect. Now we just wait for that to dry and I'll sand it. Okay, so now the resin has just gone off, so it is now not a liquid anymore and becoming a solid. I am going to rip off the tape. There we go. And successfully, no resin leaked outside of the reservoir. So one little trick I've got up my sleeve is you grab a little razor and then we cut any excess overflow like this off, and that will save you sanding it in a minute. Just leave a little bit, that cut the rest off. Once it's cut, you should be able to pull off a nice chunk. You're gonna do this just when it's like not sticky to touch, but still feels like a jelly. So it'll be a little sticky to touch, but not like it's gonna stick to you and be irritating. Sort of like that type of substance. Like a jelly. A strong jelly. Okay, now that's all cut off. We're going to wait for the rest of that to harden and then we'll sand it down and then we'll pull the tape. Awesome. All right, so just plugged in the sander and now it is time to sand off the excess off here. You might not have it depending on what fin, I mean, leash plug you have, but I have it. So simple. Damn, I just can't wait till I get home. What the hell is taking so long? I wish I had a girl by my side. Wish I had a brand new ride. I wish I had a light. I wish I had a private flight. I wish upon a star sometime. I wish I had it right. I wish I had the finer things. I wish it wasn't so Cobain. I wish I had you. Shit. And I wish I wasn't stuck on Central. Just so good at being in. And there you have it. Once it's been sanded down flush, you then pull the last piece of tape. There we have a successful leash plug installation. So if you did enjoy that, like, subscribe, and I'll see you with the next one. Yew!
spending my days out in the ghetto. Papa say that I need to be careful. Heard a nigga just got popped at the Arco. Pros on the Hostro, junkies on Narcos. Long Beach, Compton, Watts to South Central. Damn, I just can't wait till I get home. Shit, that's when a cop had pulled me over.